Morning everybody. I'm Pitanit Loblom from Faculty of Agriculture, Natural Resource and Environment in Arizona University, Thailand. Today I'm going to talk about my research in the topic of production and characterization of fermented rice flour for
Could
milling.
you open the camera on?
Oh, sorry.
We need to capture your figure.
Sorry.
Thank you.
In the topic of production and characterization of fermented rice flour for milling in Surin rice, and effect of partial substitution for fermented rice flour for milling in Surin rice quality. The content for presenting include in this slide. Sorry. Firstly, I would like to introduction. Rice Oryza sativa rice is staple food over 65% of the global population, especially Asian country. Rice can be classified by color as white rice and color rice. Color rice contain red dead purple or black pigmentation. Black and red rice is commonly used as functional food and food colorant. It contains several antioxidant compounds, including phenolic, anthocyanin, flavonoid, tannin, and gamma arsenol. The most abundant anthocyanin in color rice were identified as cyanidine pyrimidine, cyanidine T-glucoside, and pyrimidine T-glucoside. And marine insulin rice. Marine insulin rice obtained from the breeding program at Surin Rice Research Center by collecting traditional rice, marine dam, from Surin Province in Thailand. And marine insulin rice, a non-glutinous rice variety, and had a dark purple precut with good cooking and eating quality due to low amylose content and its aroma. And total phenolic content and anthocyanin of this rice variety were 1,592 milligram gallic per 100 gram and 5.5 milligram per 100 gram respectively. This compound helped to reduce the risk of coronary artery disease and inhibit growth of human colon cancer cell with IC50 value ranking between 12.6 to 76.1 ppm. And rice noodle and all khanom jin. Khanom jin mainly consumed in Southeast Asian country. Rice noodle production method are classified into unfermented and fermented process. The fermented rice noodle production involve soaking of the broken rice grain. Broken rice grain were stored for over 6 months per loy, and denning, fermenting, rinsing, grinding, steaming, kneading, etuding, boiling, and cooling. During fermentation, the microorganisms involved include lactic acid bacteria, for instance, lactobacillus species, pedococcus species, enterobacter species, yeast, and fungi. These microorganisms leading to the taste, acidity, flavor, and texture of fermented rice flour. So the aim of this study were to determine the impact of fermentation on the physical chemical property, rheological property, and bioactive compound of fermented rice flour. And second tool is to study effect of fermented marine insulin rice flour substitution on the physical chemical property, rheological property, and bioactive compound of rice noodle. Then research methodology of work. Material consisting broken rice of marine insulin obtained from Kampong Phet province in Thailand and China rice purchased from local market in Phetsanulok province Thailand. For fermented rice flour production, start with the clean of two rice variety were soaked in water for 2 hours and then for 10 minutes. And fermentation in a tray dryer at 40 degrees Celsius for 9 hours and continue fermented at room temperature for the rest of the day. After 72 hours, fermented rice washed with water, wet milling using a blender, centrifuge for 5 to 10 minutes. And die at 40 degrees Celsius for 10 hours. And I found what regarding followed by passage to 100 met 50 and see in polyethylene bag and store it at 4 degrees Celsius until further use. The picture both is fermented cyanide light or FCHI and picture below is fermented marine insulin light foul or FSU. For fermented rice noodle production, the rice noodle production were produced by replacing FCHI with FSU foul at the level of 0, 10, 20, and 30% of the foul weight. First step, both fermented rice foul were adjusted the moisture content to 45%. Then 35% of CHI foul was pre-gelatinized by mixing foul with water and meat in the pan. And pre-gelatinized foul was then mix the remaining foul and warm water and kneaded. Then 25% tapioca starch and water were added to the paste and continue knead until homogeneous. The paste was then filtered and extruded to the dye into boiling water around 85 to 90 degrees Celsius for 20 to 30 seconds. And the noodle immediately cool, and then to obtain fat noodle and light noodle was stored at 4 degrees Celsius for further analysis. The fermented rice noodle were designed at R0, R10, R20, and R30 follow replacement percent of FSU. This slide mentioned about determination of light and fermented rice foul compile chemical analysis part and physical analysis part. For determination of fermented rice noodle, compile chemical analysis part and physical analysis part and statistical analysis. Next, I will talk about experimental result. Chemical composition, amylose content, and the total starch content of rice and fermented rice foul are shown in table 1. The moisture content of raw rice and fermented rice foul ranking from 10.31 to 12.70%. Protein and lipid content decrease after fermentation in FCHI sample compared with raw rice, except FSU sample. Amylose and total starch content increase after fermentation in FCHI and FSU sample. Table 2 show the pH value and color of rice and fermented rice foul. The pH value of our sample ranking from 3.97 to 6.32, and the pH value of both rice variety significant decrease after fermentation caused by ingest of lactic acid from lactic acid bacteria. The raw rice and fermented rice foul show a significant decrease. Show significant difference in color value. A significant increase in light net and decrease in yellow red net and yellow net of both fermented light foul was observed compared to unfermented light foul. Table 3 show pasting profile of light and fermented light foul. The P viscosity of SU foul was higher than CHI foul, showing that SU sample had high viscosity with high swollen sarcano. Both fermented light foul had high peak viscosity value compared to unfermented light foul, with what attribute to enzymatic hydrolysis of protein on the surface of starch, leading to purify of sarcano. And breakdown value of CHI foul was lower than SU foul. The breakdown value of both foul after fermentation were higher than raw rice due to proportion of crystalline of sarcano increase, and setback value of SU foul were lower than CHI, indicating low retrogradation of SU, which caused by the rearrangement of low lead amylose molecule. The CHI foul after fermentation had higher setback value compared to raw rice due to increased amylose content after structure of amylopectin was hydrolyzed. And SU foul after fermentation had higher setback value caused by shearing and heating, caused structure start structure of the low amyloid of light to easily disrupt. Table 4 show pH value, color, and texture of light noodle. Substitution of FSU found affected pH value of light noodle. Increasing level of FSU found substitution from 0 to 30% decrease pH value of light noodle due to high acidity of FSU found. And increasing level of FSU found substitution significant decrease light net, but increase red net and yellow net of light noodle owing to purple dark polycarb color of marine insulin light. And the texture parameter of light noodle indicate significant decrease in hard net and adhesive net of light noodle at the level of FSU found substitution increase. Next slide, figure 1 show viscoelastic property G palm and G double palm of light noodle paste with different level of fermented marine insulin light substitute. Found that storage modulus and load modulus tend to increase with increasing frequency for all paste sample. The paste sample has higher value of storage modulus than load modulus over the test frequency, indicating that elastic property were predominant. However, when the line noodle were repeated with FSU, both modules decrease at the level of FSU increase. It may be caused by low amyloid of FSU. And the paste sample show the weak gel-like characteristic. Figure 2 show tan delta or rod tangent of line noodle paste. Found that the result indicate that amyloid positively affected on the formation of the strong structure. And tan delta of our sample was lower than 1 represent the predominant of elastic component. Figure T show viscosity property of light noodle paste. Found that our sample had high similar viscosity pattern. The viscosity decreased with increasing shear rate, showing rheological behavior of non-Newtonian type.
And sorry, 3 minutes remaining.
Yes. And inhibiting of shear thinning pseudoplastic characteristic. And the final viscosity was lower viscosity during initial shearing. Final table, table 5 show the total fluid content and antioxidant activity of light, fermented light foul and light noodle. Found that SU and FSU foul contain high amount of total fluid content compared to CSI and FCSI foul. And the reduction in total fumaric after fermentation was observed in SU foul caused by processing step include soaking, fermenting, and dyeing. And anthocyanin found in color light can dissolve easily in water, but even it stable in low pH. And the total fluid of light noodle tend to increase at the level of FSU substitution increase. For DPPH, radical scavenging of FCHI was lower than CHI. In contrast, the pH value of FSU was higher than SU. The increasing of the pH value after fermentation may be caused by stability of anthocyanin as antioxidant and at low pH. For light noodle, the pH value significant increase with increasing amount of FSU substitution from 0 to 30%. For FAP assay, the results show that FRAP value of both rivalry decrease after fermentation process indicate that some biotic compound loss during fermentation. Conclusion of my research were the fermentation process had an effect on property of foul and light noodle. Protein content of foul decrease while amyloid and hydrostat increase. And the fermented light foul had high pH viscosity to break down final viscosity and setback compared to unfermented light foul. Storage modulus of light noodle paste decrease when increasing level of FSU foul substitution. And storage modulus or paste sample were higher than load modulus. And repeatment of FCHI with FSU reduced the hardness and adhesiveness of rice noodle. FSU found substitution increased antioxidant activity and methylphenolic content of rice noodle. However, proportion of replacing FSU found on some food additive addition to improve texture in fermented rice noodle should be further investigated. The author thanks to Office of the Ministry of Higher Education, Science, Research and Innovation for providing financial support for this project that was coordinated by Nelson University. Thank you for attention.
Professor Teresa, could you turn on your microphone now?
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Piranit. Is that correct? Yeah. So, is there any question from the audience?
Yes, there are three questions from the audience.
Okay, please go ahead.
Okay. The first question is, why is the researcher interested in China rice and Malinin Surin rice?
Yeah.
Why the yes?
Okay. For Malinin Surin rice, I'm interested to increase the value of bokeh rice and actually community in Japan sell bokeh rice low price than light gain, and review found that using bokeh rice can reduce the calorie of fermentation and maybe positive effect on the texture of rice noodle. And for China rice I have the prelim by using different rice, different variety rice, and that time I from prelim experimental when I compare the several light variety until obtain the lead variety that can exude until apparent of light noodle compete.
Okay, for the second, which rice is the best used for rice noodle? Why?
Sorry, again, please.
Which rice is the best used for rice noodle? Why?
Which variant is good for making the rice noodle?
Right. Yes.
Can you hear?
He said I'm here. You mean white rice or color rice?
The rice noodle. Which one? Is the rice best,
which one?
I mean, popular in the market. Which variant is popular in the market? Or have the better taste or whatever? I mean, to make the rice noodle, you there are many varieties, right? And the audience just wonder, which one is the best to make the rice noodle?
Oh, okay. I try all three rice variety include leung patil rice, leung on rice, and China rice. I found China rice is the best for rice noodle for this study.
That your study, but I mean in the market, actually which one is very popular?
I think Sao Hai rice. Actually for rice noodle production usually using hard rice which it hard rice have high amylose content which high amylose content affected better affected on texture of rice noodle.
Okay, so any variants that have the amylose will be better to make noodle rice. Okay, I think we run out of time, isn't it?
We have around 3 minutes remaining. So for we have the last question for
so
you.
Do we have any questions? Just for the
yes. The last question is, why did the concentration of phenolic compounds increase after fermentation in rice? Which in contrast to surin rice, why did the concentration of phenolic compound increase after fermentation of chaynut rice, which in contrast to surin rice?
Can you understand? So when you ferment the rice, the phenolic compound make the increase or decrease. It depends on the variety of the rice. The audience just wonder what is the reason why the phenolic compound is very different between the variants of the rice after fermentation.
I think relate about structure of phenolic structure of phenolic of variant life variety.
Maybe relate
about change structure of this life.
Maybe some enzymes or something. Maybe some enzymes that create the difference or something like that.
Maybe. Yes.
Okay. How about the time? What we have?
So we run out of time now.
Okay. So thank you very much, Ms. Piranich.